I'm here in the meatpacking district where buckets of animal blood were spilled after cows and pigs were eviscerated on meat hooks. And then after that, Sex and the City made it famous because the girls used to hang out here. And speaking of girls, I'm here today with a very exciting guest, one of my favorite people on TV. Please welcome to Billy on the Street, Miss Lorna Doone. I mean, Lena Dunham. How are you, Lena?
Really great. Thanks. Happy to be here.
Thank you so much for being here. I just want to pinch your cheeks.
Thank you.
Can I do it?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Do it.
Ah!
Great.
You're adorable.
Thank you so much. You're adorable. I'm thrilled, and I hope I win all the games.
I think you're going to do very well.
Woo!
So thank you for being here on Billy on the Street. Now, are you familiar with the show?
Very. I love it.
Okay, wonderful. I love your show as well. And I'm going to try not to ejaculate on you because, let's face it, it's been done. But I think we're going to have a lot of fun anyway.
I think so, too.
Okay, now, in honor of our beautiful milking cow that we have here, we are about to play one of my new favorite games that I like to call Steve Harvey or Harvey Milk. Here's how it's going to work, Lena. I'm going to give you a fact. You have to tell me if that fact refers to comedian Steve Harvey or late politician Harvey Milk. Do you understand?
I understand.
Okay, if you get enough right in time, you win a big prize. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, here we go. Here we go, here we go. This is Lena Dunham playing Steve Harvey or Harvey Milk. Put time on the clock, please. And away we go. Was the first openly gay person to be elected to office?
Harvey Milk.
Yes, correct. Appeared in the movie Madea Goes to Jail.
Steve Harvey.
Yes, correct. One said, if a bullet should enter my brain, let that bullet destroy every closet door.
Harvey Milk.
Yes, correct. One favorite new talk show host of the 39th Annual People's Choice Awards.
Steve Harvey.
Yes, correct. One said that women should not date atheists who he claimed have no moral barometer and said he refuses to speak to anyone claiming to be an atheist who he said are idiots.
Steve Harvey.
Yes, correct. One said the fact is more people have been slaughtered in the name of religion than for any other single reason. That, my friends, is true perversion.
Harvey Milk.
Yes, correct. One said about evolution, you can't tell me we evolved from monkeys, then why we still got monkeys?
Steve Harvey.
Yes, correct. One said, I know you can't live on hope alone, but without hope, life is not worth living, so you gotta give them hope. You gotta give them hope.
Harvey Milk.
Yes, correct. Played the voice of an insect in the movie Racing Stripes alongside Frankie Muniz as a zebra who thinks it's a racehorse.
Steve Harvey.
Yes, correct. Tells funny jokes about what black people would have done on the Titanic.
Steve Harvey.
Yes, did she get it? Yes, you win, Lena Dunham. You win Steve Harvey or Harvey Milk.
I feel so good about that.
Let's see your prize. Oh, it's a huge picture of America's sweetheart, Zasha Mamet. Look at that.
I'm a winner.
Yes.
She looks pissed.
She does. I was going to ask you, is this her when she's happy or when she's upset?
It's hard to say. I would say that this is her when she's upset, but considering entering the world of happiness.
Oh, I love it. Thank you, Lena Dunham.
I'm so happy. I already have a painting of Zasha Mamet in my house. This will go right next to it.
Everyone needs two pictures of Zasha Mamet on their wall.
Kudos to you for pronouncing her name right.
Yeah, I looked it up. I Googled it.
It's not Zozaya.
Oh, I
didn't
think it was
Zozaya. When I first met her, I thought her name was Zozaya Mamet.
Oh, wow. That's a great story. Lena Dunham, thanks so much for being here. Congrats on playing Steve Harvey or Harvey Milk and winning.
Woo!
We'll be right back. Hey guys, I'm Billy Eichner, and this is Funny or Die's Billy on the Street, a music and pop culture game show. Now it's time to hit the streets and see what New Yorkers have to say this week. Here we go. Miss, for a dollar, name a singer that doesn't exist. Go.
George Holiday.
Yes, correct, George Holiday. What kind of music does he sing?
Classical? He doesn't sing.
He doesn't sing.
Then
he's not a singer, is he? God damn it! Sir, for a dollar, name a dead person. Go.
Benjamin Franklin.
Yes, yes. Yes. You love Benjamin Franklin?
Yeah, he was good, man. I wish he was a president, though.
Yeah, he wasn't.
He wasn't, right? Unfortunately.
Yeah.
It sucks, man.
It really sucks.
But thanks I appreciate you taking my time. I'm gonna catch you guys later.
Okay, bye. Sir, the Muppets are back.
Say again?
The Muppets.
Your Muppet?
You know Kermit, Miss Piggy?
Oh, yeah.
Of course, the Muppets.
Okay, so what about it?
They have a new movie with Tina Fey and Ricky Gervais.
All right. Cool.
Who's your favorite Muppet?
The vampire one.
The vampire?
Yeah.
There's no vampire Muppet.
Yes.
No, there's no vampire Muppet.
I don't know.
No, you're thinking of Sesame Street, asshole.
Oh, you f***ing asshole.
Miss, for a dollar, in the Muppets Most Wanted, which Muppet will finally have a breakout year? Do you think it's Janice's turn to shine?
Sure.
Which is your favorite Muppet?
Elmo?
Elmo is not a Muppet, he's on Sesame Street. That's not funny.
I have no idea.
You don't know the Muppets? You don't know the Muppet? Kermit, Miss Piggy, Gonzo?
Oh, right. Oh, well, Miss Piggy.
Yeah, of course. What about Gonzo?
Not so familiar with Gonzo.
You don't know Gonzo? The little... I don't know what he is!
Sir, for a dollar, put this photo of Jonathan Taylor Thomas in your back pocket.
Okay.
Yeah, put it in there. I gotta see it go in. Look at that ass. Here's the dollar.
All right.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Enjoy your photo of Jonathan Taylor Thomas.
He licking my ass.
Now it's time to play my new favorite game, Screaming Tweets. I'm going to run around New York and get people to scream out some of my favorite celebrity tweets. Let's go.
Sir, for a dollar, scream this tweet by Zooey Deschanel. Scream it.
Being away from...
Scream it!
Being away from my dogs, it feels like my camera has no purpose.
Yes, correct. There you go. Let's go.
Scream and tweet. Miss, for a dollar, scream out this tweet by Lenny Kravitz. Scream it.
Here's the trailer for Lee Daniels, the butler.
Yes, correct. There you go. Take it. Bye.
We're screaming tweets. Sir, for a dollar, scream this tweet. Just scream it. Scream it.
Oh, realize that you're actually really sick on the day. Of a sold-out show is a whole new level of stressful.
Yes, correct. There you go.
That's Taylor Swift, and we're screaming tweets! Sir, for a dollar, scream this tweet from Mariska Hargitay. Scream it.
Congrats on your Emmy, Carson Daly. I want to be you.
Yes, there you go. Take it. Take it.
We're screaming tweets! Miss, for a dollar, scream this tweet from Patricia Heaton. Scream it.
Cleaning out the garage this weekend. Feel bad about throwing away the boys' elementary school artwork, but trying to clear some space.
Yes, there you go. Take your dollar.
Oh, thank you.
Yes, we're screaming tweets now, motherfucker. Miss, for a dollar, scream this tweet by Ricky Gervais. Scream it.
Thanks again for all your beautiful comments about Derek. And thank you to Netflix for making it possible.
Yes, there you go. Take your dollar. Yes, we're screaming tweets. Miss, for a dollar, scream this tweet from Seth MacFarlane. Scream it.
Preparing for Family Guy live in Toronto.
Yes, correct. There's your dollar. We're screaming tweets. Here we go. Cash cow. Lena Dunham versus Elena.
Billy on the streets.
I'm here in the meatpacking district where they used to slaughter and butcher livestock, but now it's where Stella McCartney sells her vegan shoes. And I'm ready to play my new favorite game, Cash Cow. We have two great contestants here today. Please welcome first from HBO's Girls, the star and creator, the wonderful Lena Dunham. How are you, Lena?
Great, thank you.
Welcome to Cash Cow.
Thank you.
And here playing opposite Lena is the one and only contestant from Billy on the Street that haunts my dreams and nightmares. Please welcome back from season two, you know her, you love her, Elena. How are you, Elena?
Fine, thanks. It's so good to see you.
What has been happening to you since you were on Billy on the Street the first time? Give us a little update.
Well, I'm not as famous as she is.
No.
However, I'm so famous.
And what was your life like before Billy on the Street? People always ask me, like, what does Elena do?
I'm in the jewelry business. It's ethnic third world art, folk art.
Beautiful jewelry. I was going to compliment it. You can see I'm interested in jewelry myself, and I'm very excited.
Me too.
And it's very ethnic. It's like Frida Kahlo. Have you ever heard of Frida Kahlo?
Yes, I've heard of Frida Kahlo. She had the unibrow, and there was a Salma Hayek thing.
Yes, and when I met you, remember I said I was on my way somewhere?
Yes, of course.
I think whoever you were would ever heard of Lila Downs.
I don't know who the hell Lila Downs
was in
is.
That movie about Frida.
What movie? Oh, she was in the Salma Hayek movie?
Yes.
Did you ever see that?
Mm-mm.
You didn't? Well, she's fabulous and she's very well known and she was playing down.
No one knows who that is.
Yes, they do. She just.
Lena Dunham doesn't know and I don't know.
Yes, they do because I know people that do. Millions of people. She just filled the outage.
I heard that Frida Kahlo and Georgia O'Keeffe had a sexual relationship.
Wow.
No.
How do you know?
Not Georgia O'Keeffe.
How do you know?
Because Frida was from Mexico, not New Mexico.
Yes, they traveled and met each other and wrote each other sensual letters.
Hear that? They traveled. They wrote each other sensual letters.
I don't care.
Okay, all right. Ladies and gentlemen, now it's time to play our new favorite game, Cash Cow. Elena, Lena, here's how it's going to work.
Okay. Yes? No, I was going to say, I've seen you on TV.
Great.
Not on that show, because is it on cable?
It's on cable.
Like HBO or something like
that? Yes, it's on HBO.
I don't have HBO.
Why don't you get it?
Because.
Okay, fine. I need to play the game.
I didn't have it for ages. It's expensive.
I know.
I need to play the game.
I like Bill Maher. Okay, do it.
Okay, great. What color is Bill Maher's hair?
Mauve.
What?
Mauve.
Huh?
Mauve.
I think it is mauve. Boy, he likes a young black lady. I'll tell you that. He does.
So what?
I didn't say it was bad.
He dated the girl who wrote Diaries of a Video Vixen.
Who was that? Zadie Smith?
I think you should look up Lila Downs.
Oh, shut up about Lila Downs already, my God.
Thing you probably carry around.
Okay, fine. Elena, I need to play the game.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. This game is called Cash Cow. I am going to ask you a series of subjective questions. When I finish and complete the question, you lift the buzzer up and you press the buzzer if you know the answer and you tell me what the answer is. Do you understand?
Sort of.
What about you?
Like this?
Get to give our answer, whoever buzzes.
I call on the buzzer that I hear first. I'll say Elena or Lena. Oh, thank you. What?
First?
What?
Your guest has to pick your famous.
Can you shut up already? God. You should just be happy to be back here.
I'm happy to see you and her.
Yeah.
And all the.
Well, you've never seen her before. You saw her. Where did you see her? Why did you see her?
She's on a lot of shows. She's.
Well, so am I.
I.
Okay, fine. At the end of the game, the loser of the game has to milk the cow. Do you understand, Elena?
Yes.
Do you understand, Lena Dunham?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. This is Cash Cow. Buzzers up. Buzzers up. Here we go. Cash Cow. Lena Dunham versus Elena. Stakes are high. And away we go. Who probably can't tell a joke? Demi Lovato or Mary J. Blige? Lena Dunham.
Mary J. Blige.
Yes, correct. Lena gets the point. What is my absolute worst nightmare? A second Holocaust or Anne Hathaway doing stand-up? Oh, Elena.
Anne Hathaway doing stand-up.
Yes, correct, Elena. Elena gets the point. Whose accent sounds less put on? Sofia Vergara or Pee-wee Herman? Elena.
Sofia Vergara.
No, Pee-wee Herman. Lena gets the point. Who's more talented, Amy Poehler or Kelly Rowland? Lena.
Amy Poehler.
Yes, correct. Yes, correct. Moving on. How do you feel, Elena?
I've never heard of either one of them.
Great. What's scarier, a serial killer on the loose or an adult that watches Once Upon a Time? Lena.
An adult that watches Once Upon a Time.
Correct. Yes, Lena gets the point. Whose concert would I rather sit through, Christina Aguilera or Weird Al Yankovic? Elena.
Christina Aguilera.
No, Weird Al Yankovic. Lena gets the point. True or for what?
I didn't hear you say Weird Al. It sounded like all one word.
What did you think I said?
Weirdle. I know who Weird Al Yankovic.
No, you think. Well, so what about Whittle? What about Whittle, the great Whittle? I think Whittle won a Kennedy Center honor last year. Here we go, continuing the game. True or false, Lil Wayne will probably name one of his daughters Spotify. Lena.
True.
Yes, correct. Lena gets the point. Who's more interesting, Selena Gomez or a box of dried apricots? Elena.
A box of dried apricots.
Yes, correct. Elena gets the point. Who would you rather have dinner with, Paris Jackson or the reunited cast of Happy Endings? Elena.
The reunited cast from Happy Endings.
No, Paris Jackson. Did you watch Happy Endings?
Nope.
Okay. Next question. Who's better? What?
Who's Paris? Oh, I know who she is.
Who is she?
Michael Jackson's daughter.
Yes, very good, Elena. Too bad that wasn't a question. Elena gets the point. Final question. Did Eva Mendes' trip to Sierra Leone change her life? Yes or sort of? Lena!
Yes!
Yes, correct! Who wins it? It's Lena Dunham! Yes! Lena Dunham wins Cash Cow! You know what that means, Elena?
I'm allergic to milk.
I'm sorry, you have to milk the cow. You don't have to drink it.
I'd have to touch it.
Yep, let's go, Elena. Here, we'll give you some help. Time to milk the cow.
Scare the cow.
Don't scare the cow. It's okay, you're not gonna scare her. Can we get Elena? You just sit down here, Elena. I'll take the buzzer. Sit down on the little stool. Sorry, you lost the game.
I didn't really. I think it was even.
No, I don't think it was. You got most of them wrong, and Lena got most of them right.
Most of them wrong.
Well, Lena got most of them right. Can you milk the cow, please?
Ew. Okay.
Milk.
Okay, see, did you see that milk?
Let me see it.
I see.
I need to see milk coming out.
I see it on the stinking.
I need to see the milk, Elena. Don't move that bucket.
Look at the milk.
Don't move your bucket, Elena.
I'm not moving it.
Okay, all right, milk.
Milk. The cow doesn't have any more milk.
Yes, it's a cow. Of course it has milk. Oh, the cow hates you, Elena.
There's milk in there. The cow loved me and it.
No, the cow. Yeah, the cow loves you. That's why I ran away.
Stupid. Look.
No, The cow hated you. I'm sorry.
The cow hated you.
No, it did not. Look, that's Cash Cow. Lena Dunham, you're the winner. Elena, thanks for being back on the show.
You're welcome.
Okay, that's Elena, ladies and gentlemen. Congrats, Lena Dunham. Yes, she won Cash Cow. Let's see her prize. Oh, it's a diorama of Ricky Gervais pitching that show Derek to Netflix execs.
It's the best prize I've ever gotten, and I'm not kidding.
It's amazing. What?
See the milk? Everyone sees it but you.
I see it, Elena, but that doesn't change the fact that the cow did not like you.
She liked me until you walked up.
Oh, shut up. Congrats, Lena. Look at this beautiful diorama of Ricky Gervais pitching Derek to Netflix executives.
I love it.
Let me see.
That, Elena. Look what you could have had.
It's going right into my storage unit.
That's right.
At least I didn't win a blanket with, like, those bugs.
What the hell are you talking about?
He gave someone a blanket once. It had probably had bed bugs.
It didn't have bugs in it.
It could have. It looked like you got it on the street.
Okay, go home. All right, that's it. That's Cash Cow. Lena, congrats. We'll be right back. Bye. What?
I don't like to lose.
Well, you did. Second time. Bye.
Sir, you want to play Quiz in the Face? You can win real money right now.
Billy on the Spit.
Sir, you want to play Quiz in the Face? You can win real money right now. What's your name?
Jim Holt.
Jim Holt. And where are you from, Jim Holt?
I'm from New York.
Oh, awesome. And what do you do here?
I'm a freelance writer, which is to say unemployed.
Okay, perfect. What do you like to write?
The last book I wrote was about why the world exists, why there's something.
Okay, all right, here we go. Here's how it's going to work, Jim. There are two questions in each round. If you get two questions wrong, you're out of the game. If you make it to the final subjective round, you win $100. If you need help answering a question, you can beg a stranger, you can pretend to laugh for 30 seconds, or you can tell me a historic fact. Do you understand, Jim?
Okay.
Okay, here we go. Round one, question one. Married, single, what's your deal?
Single.
Okay, gay?
No comment.
All right. Why no comment?
Because it's not fit for public consumption.
Why not?
I'm not going to have that debate with you. We're playing a quiz game.
I'm just curious.
This is not it.
I just don't understand.
I think this interview is over. Very nice talking to you.
Okay, thank you so much. Gay, gay, gay! Hey guys, it's Billy, and just like Tyler Perry, I hate art and I'm doing everything in my power to destroy it. So I'm about to run up to New Yorkers, and every time they answer a question correctly about Tyler Perry's movies and TV shows, I'm gonna destroy a piece of art. Here we go. Sir, who did Tyler Perry play in a movie? An old black lady or Idi Amin in The Last King of Scotland?
He played an old black lady.
Yes, correct! Let's go! Miss, what movie did Tyler Perry direct? A Madea Christmas or 12 Years a Slave?
Madea's Christmas.
Yes, correct! Correct! Let's go! I'm bleeding! Miss, what is the name of the character Tyler Perry plays? Madea or Latifah Klump?
It's Madea.
Yes, it is! Yes, it is Madea! Correct! Let's go! Miss, yes or no, has Tyler Perry ever won a BET Comedy Award?
Yes.
Yes, correct! Correct! Sir, which movie did Tyler Perry direct? Diary of a Mad Black Woman or Diary of a Wimpy Kid?
Diary of a Mad Black Woman.
Yes, that's right! Correct! 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 God damn it! Sir, which of these is a Tyler Perry movie? Madea's Family Reunion or the Dallas Buyers Club?
Madea's Family Reunion.
Correct! Let's go! Sir, what is the name of the Tyler Perry movie? I Can Do Bad All By Myself or Blue Is the Warmest Color?
I Can Do Bad All By Myself.
Correct! Let's go! Sir, which is an actual Tyler Perry movie? Madea Goes to Summer Camp or Madea's Family Reunion?
Go f*** yourself.
Okay, thank you. Now, Lena, this is a game I like to call HBO's Girls or the Berenstain Bears. I'm going to give you a title, and you have to tell me whether it's the title of an episode of your show, HBO's Girls, or the title of a book featuring the Berenstain Bears. Bad Friend.
HBO's Girls.
Yes, correct. Homework Castle.
The Berenstain Bears.
Yes, correct. Vagina Panic.
HBO's Girls.
Yes, The Big Honey Hunt.
Berenstain Bears.
Yes, The Trouble with Grown-Ups.
The Berenstain Bears.
Yes, final one, The Broken Piggy Bank.
Berenstain Bears.
Yes, correct, you win, Elena Dotto. Let's see your prize. Oh, it's an Orange is the New Black baby mobile.
Okay, this one I'm actually keeping.
Congratulations on winning HBO's Girls versus the Berenstain Bears. Here's your Orange is the New Black baby mobile.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Lena.
It means a lot.
Oh, look who's still here. Look who didn't go anywhere. Hi, Elena.
My camera doesn't work.
Of course it doesn't.
But I wanted to see that. It's so cute.
No, you're not in this game.
I was just looking at it.
Fine. I'm sorry about that.
No, it's okay. Actually, I like Elena maybe more than you do.
Okay. That's very likely.
I connect with Elena.
Okay, we all do. Elena, will you, can you go? Okay.
City, you know, I live right up there.
I live up there too, actually. Hell's Kitchen.
Well, I live closer.
Okay, good. Then go there. Go there. Okay, that's it. Bye!
Gadoosh.